In the last 300 years, we have discovered the laws that govern the universe in all but the most extreme conditions. I think there is a reasonable chance that we may find a complete set of laws by the end of the century if we don't blow ourselves up first. If we do find a complete unified theory, it will be a great triumph, not just for scientists, but for ordinary people as well. In time, the unified theory would be simplified and taught in schools, at least, in outline. Then, everyone would have some idea of how the universe works.
Well, that is a tremendous vision. Now, Carl Sagan, you wrote an introduction to the book, and one of the striking things that you said is that it's only children nowadays who ask the big questions because they don't know enough not to.
What I was trying to get across was the notion that the school system, it seems to me, have an attitude of discouragement of asking fundamental questions. If a 5 or 6 year old asks why the moon is round or why grass is green, the usual adult answer, at least in my experience, is to discourage the child. Say, what shape did you expect the moon to be? Square. What color did you expect the grass to be? Instead of saying that those are interesting questions, let's try to find out the answer, or maybe nobody knows the answer, and when you grow up, you'll be able to discover the answer. It would be very healthy for the human species if there were less discouragement and more scientists.
This was a real big bang, not a puny thing that took place on the stock exchange a couple of years ago. It was the beginning of the universe, and of time getting a little universe, and of time itself. That happened before the big bang that did not affect what happened after. So we can neglect events, so we can neglect things before you began at the big bang. After the Big Bang, we believe that the universe expanded in a very rapid, inflationary manner. Again, this inflation in the universe quite puts modern economic inflation in the shade. An increase of billions of percent in a tiny fraction of a second. Of course, that was before the present government.
By putting into layman's terms what is available.
beyond which it goes is not much older. It is part of a galaxy which is perhaps 10 or 12,000 million years old, which is one of perhaps hundreds of thousands. Elementary particles which slowly evolved into the kind of universe we know today. We are the product of a grand evolutionary sequence, cosmic evolution, about which we are only occasionally aware. Great accomplishments.
Or whether they're not.